Hey guys, Nathan here from Midwest Outdoor Experience. Today I'm going to show you how I trained my dog to find deer sheds. So we have this soft plastic rubbery model that you can get down to the wire and use a string to keep your scent off it. I've found out that it's just a little bit too big for my 10-week-old lab, Remy Sit. Remy Sit. Good girl. And it's just a little bit too intimidating and big for her. So we are gonna use this small antler that's been gnawed down on by squirrels. And it seems like she can pick it up pretty easy. So, hey, Remy, Remy, sit. Ready? Remy, find the bone.
I've gotta say, probably the most important thing, especially for starting out, is just remember to be patient with your pup. It's not going to be perfect every time. They're not always going to bring your antler back every time in the beginning, but eventually they will catch on and they will get a pattern and realize that, hey, if I bring this antler back, I'm going to get praised and get a treat. So stay persistent and be patient, especially in the beginning, and good things will come and your dog will learn quickly.
Remy, find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Good girl. Yes. Good girl.
Whatever you decide to make the command for your dog, in my case, to find the bone, I make sure I repeat numerous times while she is finding it so that it can start to become familiar to her, and then she can realize what I want from her eventually. Whenever I say it, and over time it will stick and she will learn as it goes along.
Remy, come. Remy, come. Remy, sit. Good sit. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone.
I really noticed a lot of progress after about 2 weeks of playing slide the bone down the hallway for her to really start bringing it back.
Got the big one. Good girl, Remy. Good girl. And she brings it back. I pick it up and we'll try again. Remy, sit. Remy, sit. Hey, Remy.
It is still very common for your puppy to get distracted at this young age. So make sure that you try to take out and eliminate any distractions that are going on or around to help the training process. I'd like to say each time we trained for about 15 or 20 minutes and then I give her a break so she doesn't get worn out on it. And we just do that once or twice a day, and you really set up a good schedule. Video.
All right, guys, round two. I have Remy going to be looking for the antlers here. I have an antler between each door. In the last section, I had all the doors closed to keep out distraction. I haven't tried this with her yet, so we'll see how she does. She knows the command, but I tend to think that she's a little camera shy because she always seems to do something a little funky whenever. I pull the camera out. So, Remy, come. Remy, come. Remy, sit. Remy, sit. Sit. Good sit. 12-week-old puppy today. Remy, sit. Hey, Remy, sit. Remy. Find the bone, Remy.
Another thing to keep in mind while you're training is that sometimes if you're using real antlers, your puppy is young. And it may be difficult for them to pick up the antler. So remember to be patient and to give them the time that they need to find the right position for the antler to get into their mouth so they can grab hold of it and bring it back to you. It takes a couple times for them to figure out exactly how they like to grab it before they pick it up comfortably every time.
Good girl, Remy. Good, Remy. Good, Remy. Good girl. Remy, come. Remy, sit. Sit. Remy, sit. Good girl. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Ah, that's why it took so long. She went for both. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Good girl. Good girl. Okay, one more. Remy, find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Hey, find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone. Use that sniffer. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Good job. Good girl, Remy. That was good. Good girl. Good girl. Good job, Remy. Let's him. Let's him. All right, Remy. Ready? Remy, let's find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Remy, find the bone.
So after Remy learned how to find the bone sliding it down the hallway, I took the antlers and scattered them throughout my house, and she learned to find them throughout my house. It took her a little bit sometimes, but eventually got the hang of it.
Find the bone, Remy. Good girl, good girl. That's one. Okay, Remy, find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone.
Sometimes to help Remy out, I would kind of walk in the area of the room of my house where I hid the antler if she was struggling or having a hard time. I kind of feel like if they are truly struggling hard enough and they just aren't getting it, that you should maybe take a step back and really continue to work with them so they don't feel like they're just not getting it.
Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone. Good girl. That's good smell. Find the bone. Where is it? Where is it? Find the bone. Come on. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. No, Remy. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Good girl. Good girl. It's right there. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, you got a couple left. All right, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone. Find the bone. Oh, yeah. You found the big one. Find the bone. She has not picked this one up yet. We'll see if it's too big for my 13-week-old pup. Oh, almost. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy.
Even at this stage in the training, you'll notice me still saying find the bone a whole bunch because I'm still trying to hammer that term in her head so that whenever she hears it, she knows that that's what she's supposed to be doing.
Good girl. Good job, Remy. Good job. Okay, last one's a trick one. Okay, come here. Come on. Got one more, Remy. In this room. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone.
So I put the last antler here, a challenge antler, on the couch, and you see me point, trying to give her the hint. I think I just made the challenge antler a little bit too early. I just should have waited a little bit longer before I gave her a challenge like that.
Good girl, Remy. Good girl. That's a good girl. I'm proud of you. Good job. So that was our first attempt of hiding them randomly throughout the house. I had my wife lock her in a room, and I just put them in wide open spaces. On the inside, and I tipped the ends of the sheds or antlers with a little bit of the antler, crushed antler hair and blood to put a little scent on it to help her find it. And it was clear to me that she was using her nose to see.
All right, guys, we're here. Remy is 14 weeks old today. This is going to be the last part of this video of the last of the inside training. She's ready to go. So, Remy, hey, Remy. Remy, come here. Remy, sit. Hey, hey, come here. Come here. Ready? Gotta get her interested. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy.
I think this video clip does an excellent job portraying when Remy hears me say find the bone, she darts to the antler and she knows she's really starting to learn at 14 weeks what find the bone means and what it means to me and what I want her to do.
Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone.
Find the bone, Remy.
Good girl. Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Two more to go. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone.
This is a big one. A little tougher to pick up.
Good girl, Remy. Good girl. Good girl. Okay, challenge antler. Remy, find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy.
No matter how old your dog is, I think it's very important to just be patient. If they are a little older, they may learn a little faster. But if they're the same age, you know, it could be even slower. So just number one thing, be patient. And it's really important to just work them. I try to work her about 5 days a week. Like I said, it's only for 10 to 15 minutes a day. So they don't get too distracted or too worn out by it. But I think overall, it's been working great. And I've really seen a lot of progress with her. And I'm super proud of how well she's been doing.
I started with a simple game of fetch down this hallway, just getting her to bring them to me. And then I started, after she got a hang of that, I started putting them down there, making her wait, and then giving her the command. And I got to the point now where, Remy, come. Where I take her, I put her outside on my deck, and drop a couple antlers down here. That one, for sake of time. That one. Have her come in. She's always roaring to come in. Come on in. Come on. Good girl. Remy, come. Hey, nope, not yet. Cheater. Come here. Come here. Remy, hey, come here. Remy, sit. Hey, sit. Good sit, Remy. Find the bone. Find the bone, Remy. Find the bone. Good girl. Good girl, Remy.
So I think that over these 4 weeks of phase one training, I think Remy has come a really long way. I'm extremely proud of her, and now our training will take us to outside, and we'll pretty much repeat these steps. Again, I'll have a video for you guys, a part two of how we did it and what we did, and I think it'll go smooth and well, and when I do, I'll update you guys and let you know. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you next time.